guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I will be filming a date lookbook. So this will be for your date nights or date days, because I will be doing day to night, casual, and a little more dressy looks for you to wear for your bae to keep it stylish and chic and cute while you are at dinner, brunch, lunch, getting coffee, movies, parks, museums, so many things to do in New York City. So let's get to it.
Thank you.
Okay guys, so for the first look I featured this dress. It is from Topshop. It is just a lightweight ribbed button-down dress. It has a couple slits on the side. It's midi length, and I paired it with my black and gold Saint Laurent sandals because they have this heel. They're pretty easy to walk in. Okay, yeah, so I wore that outfit to Fig and Olive, which is a decently priced restaurant. All black, night look. I also showed you guys this look, which is one of my favorites. This denim jumper with the that ties at the waist and zips all the way down. You can definitely wear the zipper how you want it, all the way up to the collar, or you can also wear it down further. I'm sorry I keep coming in closer to the camera, but I want you guys to be able to hear me. Then it cuts off top of my head, so I apologize for that. This is a fun piece because it gives me like real 70s vibes, and I think I would definitely wear this to like a party, like with a heel, like a chunky heel, as well as how I wore it just again with the Chanel trainer situation. Another look I showed you was this skirt, which was featured in another video of mine. I just love it so much, and I haven't even worn it yet, but I will be wearing it how I just showed you in this video. Now that it is warmer outside, I'm gonna be wearing it paired with that white basic crop top and my clear Cinderella heels, I like to call them, from Jeffrey Campbell. This dress from And Other Stories, it is a leopard print wrap dress. It is a true midi length on me, which means it comes way past the knee. But since it is a true wrap dress, it does have a high split. I wore this actually to the Central Park Zoo, and at that time I had paired it with my Chanel trainers, but for the sake of this video I also wanted to do a mixed print look, and so I wore it with these snakeskin booties. So I went to Central Park and I was walking around, I went to the zoo, and then I also went to the Loeb Boathouse, which is a pretty nice restaurant overlooking the water. It can be romantic, so I think a dress like this that's so light and easy and fresh is perfect for that day to night look. This shirt, the sheer polka dots, it's lined in the front, but it is completely sheer in the back, and it has a puff sleeve paired with the flared trousers and slides. Is a great look for just going on a coffee, or in my case, matcha latte date, or a brunch, or a lunch. I even wear that to like a gallery or museum type of situation, but definitely a more casual but chic, stylish look. So this dress, the black button down with the like flared cut high low shirt dress, Topshop. It is a brand called Absence of Color. This dress with the white block heel pumps I wore on a date to brunch and the Whitney Museum. I also showed you guys this look that I am currently still wearing. It is this polka dot top with denim cropped jeans. I wore this outfit actually right out of the store. Both these items are from Topshop, and I wore them to actually just go shopping on Fifth Avenue. So this was definitely a cute, stylish, easy look for shopping. Yeah, at that time I did wear this outfit with the white pumps, but I do like how it looks with my my cork low block heels and the natural color from Schutz. That was also a decent look, and I'll probably wear that sometime this week. Another look I showed you was this skirt, which was featured in another video of mine. I just love it so much, and I haven't even worn it yet, but I will be wearing it how I just showed you in this video. Now that it is warmer outside, I'm gonna be wearing it paired with that white basic crop top and my my clear Cinderella heels, I like to call them, from Jeffrey Campbell. Some those are shoes that do have a low heel, but because of the material and because of the shape, they do hurt my feet, so that is definitely one of my just like get grabbing food type of looks. No walking in those. And last but not least, I did want to give like a sexy outfit because I know like I definitely like to be a little sexy sometimes on my dates. And so I have this skirt from Zara. It is a faux leather mini skirt with this this detail on it, which makes it actually makes you look a little more curvy, even if you're not curvy. And then this wrap blouse that I had from Topshop that I love wearing. I wore this to dinner a few times last summer. And then again, I paired that with my Saint Laurent heels. And then I also wore this orange trench coat because usually when I'm wearing things that are short, I kind of like to wear a jacket that is long. Sometimes you walk and your skirt rides up, and sometimes usually would cover yourself fully and not feel as naked. So that is an outfit I'd wear to dinner. I actually wore a very similar version of that outfit last summer to on a sushi date. I hope I got all my outfits in. I'm sorry this video is very rushed. So I hope you guys like this video, and I hope if you get some inspiration from these looks, comment down below. Let me know which ones you would wear and which ones you would not wear. Make sure you give me a thumbs up and make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any more of my videos. Bye.